हाय एवरीवन, दिस लेक्चर इज ऑन बियरिंग। बियरिंग इज ए मशीन एलिमेंट। बियरिंग आर मशीन एलिमेंट दैट परमिट्स रिलेटिव मोशन ऑफ टू पार्ट्स इन वन और मोर डायरेक्शंस विथ ए मिनिमम फ्रिक्शन व्हाइल प्रिवेंटिंग मोशन इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ अप्लाइड लोड। दिस इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ बियरिंग। बियरिंग आर मशीन एलिमेंट। इट इज ए मशीन एलिमेंट दैट परमिट्स रिलेटिव मोशन। द फंक्शन ऑफ बियरिंग इज टू परमिट रिलेटिव मोशन ऑफ टू पार्ट्स इन वन और मोर डायरेक्शन विथ ए मिनिमम फ्रिक्शन। बियरिंग शुड बी लाइक दैट इट हैज मिनिमम फ्रिक्शन वाइल प्रिवेंटिंग मोशन। इट ऑल्सो prevent motion in the direction of applied load. This is the complete definition of bearing. Means if you see this definition, there are three important points: that bearing permits relative motion in one or more directions. Due to this relative motion, friction and wear, the role of friction and wear comes out. Another important point is that it permits relative motion with a minimum friction. Due to this minimum friction, the role of lubrication comes out. And third important point is, it prevent motion in the direction of applied load. It means it behaves like a support. This point suggests that bearing acts like a support because it prevent motion in the direction of applied load. So there are three functions of bearing: to permit relative motion, it must have minimum friction, that means lubrication, and it prevent motion, that is support reaction. Now this is the example. Suppose here it is written relative motion means friction and wear. Minimum friction means lubrication. Preventing motion means it acts like a support. Now see this figure. This is the shaft and this is the bearing. Okay, bearing is an stationary part, so here stationary bearing is shown. Between bearing and shaft there is a lubricant. Here this is the lubricant, this is the lubricant, this is the shaft, this is the bearing. Now suppose on this is here some part of shaft is shown. Suppose on this shaft there are gear and pulley. Suppose this is the spur gear. On spur gear two types of forces are acting: radial force and tangential force. And this is the pulley. On pulley there is a belt and the belt has two tensions, F1 and F2. So net force on pulley will be F1 plus F2, and this force will be act at the shaft at this point. Similarly, suppose this is the spur gear, there are two force, radial force and tangential force. These two forces are acting on the shaft like this, FR and FD. Now this due to the FD, or this is the force, belt force. Suppose the torque applied on the shaft is T. Now the function of bearing is to allow the relative motion. Here the torque is acting on the shaft, so due to this torque the shaft is rotating. So here rotation motion is allowed by the bearing. And for minimum friction and wear, lubrication is required. Because bearing must have the minimum friction, so here lubricant is used. Where the rubbing surfaces are present, there lubrication must be used. So now this force Fr and Ft, this force will be supported by the bearing, means there is no motion along Fr and Ft. It means it bear the, if you see the side view of the bearing, it's like a circle. Here the side view is shown. Here is not shown. In the next slide it is shown. The bearing permits the rotation motion of the shaft. There is a lubricant to minimize the friction and wear, and the motion of shaft along the applied load Fr and Ft is not permitted. So this is the bearing. It has three functions: to allow the motion in one or more direction, another it has should have minimum friction, so lubricant is used, and third it prevent motion along the direction of applied load. Now for this bearing, if you see the side view from here, if you see the side view from here, side view of bearing will be the circle. Suppose this is the bearing and suppose this is the shaft. The side view of the bearing and side view of the shaft. Now this Fr and this Ft, both are acting. Suppose this is the Fr and suppose this is the Ft. This is the Ft. Both forces are radial to this bearing, because suppose this is the center, then this force and this force both are radial for the bearing. So this bearing is designed to support radial load, either Fr or Ft, or you can take F1 plus F2. This is also the radial load for the bearing. I will discuss in detail in next slide what why I am emphasizing on the radial load. Okay, so this time you must understand that bearing has three roles: to allow relative motion between two rubbing surfaces, and due to this relative motion or rubbing, a friction is developed, so friction should be minimum, and for this the role of lubrication comes out, and third, prevent the motion along the applied load, and this indicate it acts like a support. Okay, now there are two types of bearing. One is sliding contact bearing and another is rolling contact bearing. You know that what is sliding contact bearing? Sliding contact bearing have sliding friction, means linear friction, means two linear rubbing surfaces have linear frictions. Sliding contact bearing are usually designed for a single purpose, either to carry radial load or to carry axial load. Here in this example, all forces are radial for the bearing. All forces, Fr, Ft, F1 plus F2, all forces are radial for the bearing. Now suppose, in spite of spur bearing, here the helical gear is mounted. In spite of spur gear, helical gear is mounted on the shaft. And you know that on the helical gear, three loads are acting: radial, tangential, and one also axial. Suppose this is the helical gear, so one force also acts. This is the axial, Fa. In this case, this axial load acts axially on the bearing. This is the bearing. This एफ आर, एफ टी एंड एफ वन प्लस एफ टू, ऑल फोर्सेस आर रेडियल हियर. सपोज दिस इज द एफ आर, सपोज दिस इज द एफ आर, दिस इज द एफ टी, दिस इज द एफ टी, दिस एफ वन प्लस एफ टू, दिस एफ वन प्लस एफ टू, सपोज दिस एफ वन प्लस एफ टू इज ऑल्सो हियर, दिस इज द एफ वन प्लस एफ टू, नेट फोर्स एफ, एफ इज द एफ वन प्लस एफ टू, एंड अनदर फोर्स इन केस ऑफ हेलिकल गियर इज एक्सियल एफ ए. दिस एक्सियल लोड एक्ट्स अलोंग द एक्सिस ऑफ द बियरिंग, दिस इज द एफ ए. सो इन दिस केस ऑफ हेलिकल गियर वन एक्स्ट्रा फोर्स इज हियर एफ ए. सो ऑन द बियरिंग टू टाइप्स ऑफ लोड आर एक्टिंग, रेडियल, दिस इज रेडियल, दिस इज रेडियल फॉर द बियरिंग, दिस इज ऑल्सो रेडियल. This is also radial for the bearing. This is also radial for the bearing. But this force is axial for the bearing. In this case, the bearing has two types of load, radial and axial. You must have knowledge that sliding contact bearing are usually designed for a single purpose, either to carry radial load or carry axial load. Means in this case, where both loads are acting axial and radial, the sliding contact bearing is not suitable. Sliding contact bearing is used where either radial load is acting or axial load is acting, or if both are acting, then one load, axial suppose, is very less than radial, means it can be neglected. Only that cases sliding contact bearing may be used. So it is written here, sliding contact bearing are usually designed for a single purpose, either to carry radial load or to carry axial load. Sliding contact bearing is not suitable to carry a combination of radial and thrust load. Thrust load means axial load. So in this case, where the radial and thrust both loads are acting, rolling contact bearing is used. And rolling contact bearing has rolling friction. You must know what is the difference between sliding friction and rolling friction. Sliding friction is a simple type of friction. If I want to explain you, suppose this is a surface and this is a surface. This has some motion. Then between these contacting surfaces, sliding contacts, this is the sliding contact and here sliding friction is used. In case of rolling friction, suppose this is the roller and suppose this is the surface and the roller rolls on the surface, then the friction between here is the rolling friction. I will explain the rolling friction or rolling contact bearing in the next lecture. Here this lecture is for sliding contact bearing. So you remember that sliding contact bearing are usually designed for a single purpose, either to carry radial load or to carry axial load, and it has sliding friction. Okay. This is an example of sliding contact bearing. This is the bearing house. This is the bearing house. This is the bronze bearing here. This bearing is made of bronze. And this is the shaft. This is the load acting on the bearing. And notice that this load is radial to the bearing. This is the revolution of shaft. This is the diameter of shaft. This is the length of the shaft inside the bearing. Again, it is very important term. The shaft inside the bearing this length is the length of shaft inside the bearing. The part of shaft which is inside the bearing is called journal. Means journal is the part of shaft which is inside the bearing. Here lubricant in there is a slot or groove or hole made through which lubricant in, and after lubricating it comes out from here, lubricant out. So here you remember that the part of shaft which is inside the bearing is called journal, and sometimes this is the bearing, this is the journal, in between the lubricant is injected. Sometimes after the bearing a different material is used, and that is called bushing. This is shown here. This is the bearing, and the red, this red color is the, this is the bushing. This is the bushing. This is the bush, and it is provided to support the bearing material so that a smooth motion is achievable, and this is the clearance for the lubricant. This is the clearance for the lubricant. So this is the diagram of sliding contact bearing. This is the bearing, this is the bearing, this is the casing, this is the bearing, this is the bush, this is the lubricant, and this is the cross section of journal. Journal is the part of shaft which is within the bearing. Okay, now here load is acting radially. This you know that the sliding contact bearing is applied either to carry radial load or carry axial load. If the sliding contact bearing is used to bear the radial load, then this type of bearing is called journal bearing. This type of bearing is called journal bearing. So in our syllabus BTE, this journal bearing is had importance. So we study journal bearing. You must remember that journal bearing is a type of sliding contact bearing which is designed to carry radial load. Okay. Okay, now come to the next slide. This is the some material used for the bearing. Here Babbitt material, plastic bronze, lead base white material. This is the part of design data book. Actually one design data book is very popular, that is of Mahadevan. This is the part of Mahadevan design data book. You must know what are the material of bearing and where it is used. So I have marked two important materials because it is very important to know. In IC engine bearings the Babbitt material is used, and in automobiles plastic bronze is used. Plastic bronze is the material. This is the metal, not the plastic. It has lead percentage greater than 30%, so that the material has greater plasticity. So it is known as plastic bronze. This is also important, but at least these two material which I have highlighted in a rectangular block must you know this. You must study all materials. This is Babbitt lead base, plastic bronze, phosphor bronze, 5th gun metal, 6th brass, 7th aluminium, 8th cast iron. This is the part of design data book. You must know which material is used for the bearing and where it is applied. Now come to the next slide. We know that the bearing has one important function of lubrication. So what is lubricant? Lubricant is used to reduce friction and wear, heating of machine parts, to prevent heating of machine parts, and to provide protection against corrosion. This is the function of lubricant. Lubricant has a function to reduce friction, to reduce heating of machine parts, and to provide protection against corrosion. These are the some important properties of lubricant. It must be chemically stable, because if it is not chemically stable, it reacts with the bearing material and chemically it corrodes the bearing surface. It must have sufficient specific heat so that the heat can be carried out. We know that the heat carried is mCp delta T, where Cp is the specific heat. So the lubricant must have sufficient specific heat to carry out the heat generated between the rubbing parts. It must be available in wide range of viscosity, because to apply in different applications, different viscosity of is required. So it must have wide range so that we can select. It must have less sensitive to change in temperature, because if there will be change in if it is sensitive to change in temperature, the property of lubricant is can be changed, and it behaves like another fluid, and it can damage the bearing surface. So it must have less sensitive to change in temperature. It must commercially available at reasonable cost, so that we can select at reasonable cost. These are the important properties of lubricant. Now, what is lubrication? Lubrication is a science of reducing friction by the application of a lubricant between two rubbing surfaces having relative motion. So it is nothing. It is the definition of lubrication. Lubrication is the science of reducing friction by the application of lubricant between two rubbing surfaces having relative motion. Now, in case of lubrication or lubricant, it behaves like a fluid. In case of fluid, the one very important parameter is viscosity. Just you remember the what is viscosity. You know that this equation, this is the Newton's law of viscous fluid, tau equal to mu into du upon dy. You know that this is the viscosity. The fluid can be treated as a number of layers. This is the layer of fluids, and the layers have relative motion, suppose u, and the gap between the layers is dy. So the Newton's defined the friction tau acting between the layers is mu into du upon dy. Here mu is dynamic viscosity. Must remember that mu is the dynamic viscosity or absolute viscosity, and you know that the SI unit of dynamic viscosity mu, the unit of tau, shear force is Newton per meter square, multiplied by dy, the unit of dy is meter, the unit of u is meter per second. So the SI unit of dynamic viscosity comes out Newton second upon meter square. Newton upon meter square can be written as Pascal, so it is Pascal second this is the SI unit. Now this in matrix system you can denote the dynamic viscosity in poise. You know that this is the unit of dynamic viscosity in matrix system, and centipoise is generally used to denote the or represent the viscosity in lubrication. This is a common practice that the viscosity of lubricant is represented in centipoise. Okay, so you must have knowledge of relation between mu, that is SI unit, and centipoise, that is Z. If you write Z for dynamic viscosity, Z means dynamic viscosity in centipoise, and mu means dynamic viscosity in SI unit. The relation between SI unit and centipoise is this: mu in SI unit, Z in centipoise. You must remember that it is used to convert the units. Mu is in SI unit and Z in centipoise. So mu equal to 10 to the power minus 3 into Z. This is the some introduction about the viscosity. Now come to the next slide. This is about lubrication. The lubrication is of two types. One is thick film lubrication and another is thin film lubrication. Actually, the surface of bearing and journal is separated by a film of lubricant. If the two rubbing surfaces are completely separated by a film of lubricant or fluid, it is called thick film lubricant. And if the lubricant film is thin and there is partial metal to metal contact between the rubbing surfaces, then it is called thin film lubrication. Means in thin film lubrication, a metal to metal contact exists. So it is also called boundary lubrication because there metal to metal contact exists in thin film lubrication. So remember that there are two types of lubrication: thick film, that means the rubbing surfaces, that is the surface of bearing and surface of journal, is completely separated by a film of lubricant, that is called thick film lubrication. If there is metal to metal contact sometimes, then it is called thin film lubrication. One also term is defined in lubrication, that is zero film lubrication. Zero film lubrication means there is no use of lubricant. Means the rubbing in between the rubbing surfaces, there is no lubricant is used. So if the lubricant is not used, then it is called zero film lubrication. Okay, so lubrication are of two type. Lubrication is of two types: thick film lubrication, thin film lubrication. Now come to the thick film lubrication. It can be two types: hydrodynamic lubrication and hydrostatic lubrication. You refer any textbook to study the hydrodynamic lubrication and hydrostatic lubrication, and what is the difference between hydrodynamic and hydrostatic lubrication. It is important. You just try to refer any textbook. In hydrodynamic lubrication, the film of lubricant between the surfaces is created by shape and relative motion of the sliding surface. Means in hydrodynamic lubrication, the film of lubricant is created by the shape of rubbing surfaces itself. Means this film of lubrication is created by the shape of rubbing surfaces. In case of hydrostatic lubrication, the film of lubricant is created by the external source, means like a pump. Okay, means in case of hydrodynamic lubrication, the lubricant is not injected by the external source. In case of hydrodynamic lubrication, the lubricant is not injected between the bearing and journal by an external source like a pump. But in the case of hydrostatic lubrication, the lubricant is exerted by a pump at such pressure that it creates a film of lubricant between the rubbing surfaces. And here the film of lubricant is created by the shape of surfaces automatically. Okay, you refer any textbook. The hydrodynamic lubricant, the journal bearing, you noted what is journal bearing? Journal bearing is a sliding contact bearing which is designed to carry the radial load. The journal bearing is an example of hydrodynamic lubrication. The journal bearing is of two types, full journal bearing, partial journal bearing. The full journal bearing is the journal bearing in which the angle of contact between the lubricant and the surfaces of bearing is 360 degree. Means the surfaces, the rubbing surfaces are, this is the rubbing surfaces, there is the lubricant from all sides, means it covers 360 degree. If it covers 360 degree, then it is called full journal bearing. If it covers less than 180 degree, then it is called partial journal bearing. This is the example of partial journal bearing. Now, there are another special lubrication, elastohydrodynamic, solid film. In elastohydrodynamic, surfaces are in rolling contact. Just like gears, roller bearing, in gears and roller bearing, elastohydrodynamic type of lubrication is used. Another is solid film, where bearing operates at extreme temperature, the solid lubricant is used like graphite, molybdenum dioxide. This is the solid lubricant. So the application where bearing operates at extreme temperature, temperature the fluid can decompose. So solid lubricant is used in that case. So these are two special lubrication, elastohydrodynamic and solid film lubrication. Now comes to the very important parameter in case of bearing, or you can say the lubricant. This is called Sebald universal viscosity. Actually the viscosity is represent or the SI unit of here it is explained what is the unit of viscosity. Here this is the unit of SI unit of viscosity is Pascal second, and centipoise is used generally in case of bearing, centipoise. Okay, this is the another different unit of viscosity here, and it is very important to know what is Sebald universal viscosity. You know the SAE, Society of Automotive Engineers. The SAE of USA has classified lubricating oils by a number like SAE 20. In case of automobile field, the lubricant is represented by a number that is called SAE 20, like SAE 20. What do you mean by SAE 20? This 20 represents the Sebald universal viscosity, so which is related to the viscosity of oil in Sebald universal viscosity. Actually ASTM, you know that the ASTM, American Society of Testing of Materials, ASTM standard there is a ASTM standard method to calculate the Sebald universal viscosity. In this method, an instrument called Sebald Universal Viscometer is used. What is Sebald Universal Viscometer? It is like a tube or pipe in which lubricant in and lubricant out. The length of this tube is 12.25 mm. This is the standard dimension given by the ASTM to calculate the viscosity of lubricant in term of Sebald universal viscosity. This is the length of 12.25 mm. A lubricant of 60 mL is passed from this through this tube. The time taken by the lubricant to in and out is called Sebald universal viscosity. So in this method, to measure the time for 60 mL lubricant is passed or to run through the pipe, and the time taken by the lubricant to pass the tube is called Sebald universal viscosity in seconds. The unit here is seconds because it is the time. Now this Sebald universal viscosity in seconds, suppose this is the T, this is not the tau, this is the T, time, this is the time, here also T. So this T time is equivalent to the kinematic viscosity. This T time taken by the lubricant to pass through this specific tube is equivalent to kinematic viscosity, and it is represented by ZK. If you here this conversion is required, this is the ZK, this is the ZK.